In VI High 49 and 50, we talked about state machines. In 49, we planned it out with the state transition diagram, and then in 50, we implemented it. At the end, we said we would discuss error handling. The question is, what happens if any of these states has an error? Well, in the previous implementation, there was no error handling. That's bad. In this situation, though, we're going to have every state transition to this error shutdown state. The error shutdown case will handle the error, whatever it is, and then shut down the application. Now, this is one possible implementation. However, in many cases, we already have a shutdown case, in which case it may look something like this, where in the case of an error, we move to the error handling state and then to the shutdown case. But if we don't have an error, we just move to the shutdown case and then end. Now, we have a lot of red arrows going all over the place. So for simplicity, we oftentimes just do this. And anything here with a red background automatically forwards to the error handler in the case that they have an error. However, we don't have a separate shutdown case. It's a pretty simple application. And so we'll just stick with this one. So what's our path forward? Well, we'll first ensure that all of the VIs in the application handle errors. Then we'll add the error shutdown case to the enum. Then make the error shutdown case in the state machine, and then fix the other cases to transition to it with an error handler. So let's do that. We'll open up again our LabVIEW project containing the state machine, and I got rid of that main that we created in VI High 50. Don't need it right now because this is the same. And we stopped here. So the first thing we'll do is ensure all VIs handle errors. Well, we'll go under the hood to the VIs. And this is where we left it last time, but appropriate error handling strategy that we learned about in VI High 48 is to wrap any code in a case structure with the error cluster going to the case selector terminal. So we'll do that. Pull down a case selector terminal and wire the error cluster into it and through to the other side. Flip over to the error case and just complete wiring the tunnels. Now in the no error case, we perform the test. In the error case, we don't, and the state machine will go and decide what to do. Now it's important to note that failing a test is not an error, because the application is designed to determine whether a device under test passes or fails. So it's doing what it should do. An error would be if the application itself fails. Maybe communication with the instrumentation fails, or the user requests the application to do something that it can't do. So those are errors. And we'll jump out of here and see that other cases with the other VIs already have that implemented. So we've ensured our VIs handle the errors. Now we'll add to the enum. That's done simply enough by going to any instance of the typedef, right-clicking and opening it up. And we want to add an error shutdown case. And I'll just add it here at the bottom. I'll expand this a bit so I can see it. Right click and add an item after. Error shutdown. Save and close it. And now all instances of the typedef will have that error shutdown as well. Huge help using that typedef. We always want to make sure that the enum going to our state machine creates a typedef, or else we'd have to go and add that item to every instance of the typedef. What a pain. So now, we'll make our error shutdown case. And we'll just put it here after notify. I'll right click, add case after, and the case structure will automatically assign the next case to the unassigned item in the typedef enum. What's going in this case? In keeping with the pattern I've already started, I'll just have a VI that does the error shutdown. It will look a lot like some of the other VIs in here, probably a lot like advanced test or notify. So I'll pull that open, take advanced test, and make a copy of it, and change it to error shutdown. Open it up. And we'll want to make sure that this is in the project. So I'll just pull it over here. And we'll definitely want to change the icon as well. So I'll just open up the icon editor. And this is our error shutdown. We'll actually have another VI later that does the error handling between cases. So we'll just look for a glyph that's shutdown. Okay, these are good. We'll get rid of the old one, select it, delete key, and click and drag this on there. Okay, save that and close it, and put this in here. We will fill in the blanks here, or the hollow tunnels, and we'll end on this case, since that's what our state transition diagram tells us to do, right here. So we'll make this true. And here, it doesn't really matter what we do here, because we're going to end our application, so we'll just leave it at an error shutdown. Of course, we need to supply an input to the tunnel so the VI can run. And looking at the guts here of our error shutdown VI, we'll have some stuff in here that does that, but it probably won't reside in the no error case, but in the error case. Or, since it's supposed to execute in an error, and only in an error, we could even get rid of this if we want. It's up to us. For now, we'll leave it as it is. And then finally, fix the other cases to transition with an error handler. And this is a big part, so we'll do this next episode. In the meantime, remember to check out 6clear.com for all your LabVIEW training needs.